Hello there. Good evening, everybody. How y'all doing? Happy Tuesday, my friends. You ready for some EPW Flux this evening? right, folks, the predictions for the opening contest are going to be up shortly. I'm getting it set up now. It is a base singles match between Supreme Knight and Trap Reaper. You were literally booked on the card 3 days ago. You were on Saturday morning cartoons. Show. You were on the card 3 days ago, my guy. You had a match. Yeah. We got a limited card size. Not everybody can be in every match, but you were on the card on Saturday, bruv. You were against Push Star Media Network. Or wrestling. You're against Push Star.
Looking to upgrade.
Christian Gaze. You were the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You were the 7th match on the card. Where the hell am I? Switchings, baby. Predictions, make prediction. Opening contest, Supreme Knight, who definitely has his own music, I'm pretty sure. Why can I not find it? Okay, I got it. All right, off to a bit of a slow start, but the following contest is our opening contest in a singles match scheduled for one fall with a 20-second ring out and a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, making his way to the ring from the other side of darkness, otherwise known as Newark, New Jersey, the Nightmare, Supreme Knight! This happens every fucking time. Supreme Knight 1-1. Taking on Trap Reaper. Trap Reaper coming into this match.
Hello there.
At 2-3. Let's read it wrong, my bad, no worries, homie. If you've got notifications on, it should put like the little red marker next to the channel if you get tagged in it. Well, I keep fucking up this music. And his opponent, making his way to the ring, from Bogota, Colombia, the Trap Reaper! We smoking? I was off the PLE and Saturday, it happens. It does happen. I try and make sure that everybody gets on the card at least once a week. And when I notice that that's not happening, I try and make a card that has people that haven't seen themselves on a card in a bit. Let's get on here. Singles match again. This is for one fall, 20-second ring out, 20-minute time limit. Is Supreme Knight going after the Trap Reaper. Punches him right in the face.
Hello there.
I spelled opening wrong. LJ, good evening. How are you? How you loving this heat here, bruv? Like fucking 97 degrees with 200% humidity? My goodness. It's like a just wearing the air going outside. Gotta change water, but yes. Oh, bong rip or a bubbler? Or something different entirely. Oh my god! A burning hammer from Supreme Knight just busting it out. On the Trap Reaper, how could you do this? ULG, hello, Deathblade, hello, Tauthar, hello. In the name of violent entertainment, hell yeah. About to go out and grill in 40 minutes because that's the only food we have right now? Oof. What is it that you're grilling? Well, I guess putting it in the oven isn't much of a better alternative if it's gonna heat up the house. Trap Reaper has Supreme Knight down on the ground. Abby, how's it going, you beautiful biscuit? How are all you homies doing today? How is your Tuesday afternoon treated you up until this point? Trap Reaper right now has the upper hand on Supreme Knight. Right hand. Another right hand. A third right hand knocks Supreme Knight down to the ground. Burgers, a pound of frozen salmon, and some lined chicken skewers. Oh, that sounds fantastic, actually. I made tacos today for Taco Tuesday. Oh, a vertebraker. My goodness, Supreme Knight busting out the big moves onto Trap Reaper, who literally doesn't care. Gonna throw some fries in the air fryer? Hell yeah, that's what I made Cammy for dinner. Air fryer fries. Oh! Supreme Knight, I thought he was gonna take the referee out, but the referee evading. I always wondered, what if you put chicken tenders on the grill? I mean, that, like, breaded or not? Breaded probably wouldn't come out as good as you would want it to. But, like, just unbreaded chicken tenders? That's probably great. And by probably, I mean, it literally is. I do that all the time. Anything is good with the... I'm gonna make tortillas tacos? Hell yeah. I had... One of them was with a tortilla. I made it like a burrito, basically. But then the other one I just had, like, in a pile, some lettuce, onion, pepper, the meat. Some hot sauce. I just ate it almost like a taco bowl. Because I didn't want, like, the tortilla. After the one tortilla, it was too heavy. Trap Reaper. Collar and elbow tie up, followed by an Irish whip into the corner. Y'all ready to see Joe Hendry on NXT tonight? When is that happening? Keep me posted, folks, on when Joe Hendry debuts, and we'll pull that up. Oh, what an elbow, but it misses! The guillotine elbow misses! Trap Reaper! Nearly put it away. Dot, dot, dot. What's with the ellipses, Prince? What has happened? I have cooked some breaded chicken patties on my barbecue. They didn't end up that crispy, sadly. But a grill, you might be able to do it. What is the difference between a barbecue and a grill? Where I come from, barbecue is either like the food genre or the act of cooking outside. I didn't know that a barbecue was also used as a method, for lack of a better term. Indirect, so like a smoker? Do we have closed captions now? We should have always had closed captions. If that hasn't been the case, whoopsie. But yeah, there should have always been closed captions. Man, 2 years ago, it was like Dr. Krabby, I think. Somebody had came in and the widget wasn't there until now? Interesting. Is it working okay, though? Like, is it accurate? But yeah, Dr. Krabby or somebody of his cut from the same cloth of like wonderful, kind human. Kick out at two there from Supreme Knight. They had a deaf member of their community who came in and they were talking about the closed caption program, and I went and I downloaded it that day. Oh, Trap Reaper. Like a griddle? Nah, like direct flame grill. Can you like send a picture to IRL Pics or something? It doesn't have to be the one that you use, but like an Amazon link or something. Because I'm definitely going to need a visual aid here. My brain is not agreeing with me when I'm trying to imagine this. Like a flat top versus a Great's barbecue? I also need a visual? Yeah. Like all I can think of is a smoker. What a huge Uranagi from Supreme Knight. What is it? Oh, he's looking for it again! Double Uranagi! He's putting Trap Reaper away! Oh my god. Supreme Knight, please. He's literally already dead. Grabs him by the face and slams him down again. Trap Reaper, I'm so sorry. One, two, three. Supreme Knight with an absolutely brutal ending to this match. My grill is a propane four burner grill? Hell yeah. Technically speaking, grilling is done over a hotter direct flame. Barbecue is slower, lower, and often with indirect heat. I'm really, outside of smoking, I'm not understanding, and this is definitely a me problem, what indirect heat is in this context. Like, do you have a fire in one room and then in the next room over, you've got like the meat sitting in the middle of the room so that as the ambient air heats up? Wood pellets. This seems like a smoker to me. I need to know what the difference is between an indirect heat grill. Yep, that's a grill. Okay, so what is a barbecue? That is what I think of when I think of grill. Let me pay out the predictions. Give Supreme Knight his win in the record column. 50-50. But Supreme Knight coming out on top goes to 2-1. Two and one. One win streak. Bouncing back. Trap Reaper, however, goes to 2-4. He's on a three loss streak.
Looking to upgrade.
Great, like, timing on that looking to upgrade. It happened right when, like, the transition sound ended. So it sounded like we transitioned into... I don't know if all barbecues do this, but mine has a shield over the flame. Grill, griddle. Okay, yeah. Now barbecue. What's a barbecue? What's the difference? I love griddles, though. Griddle is one of my favorite ways to cook. Like a flat top. Aw, oh, man. Those are fantastic. What is our second contest? On on the match cards today, we've got an elimination chamber in the women's division. Six superstar elimination chamber featuring the likes of Oh She Fancy, the Thought Princess. We've got Blue Siren of the Isle of Queens. We've got Jawzette of Jawzette. We've got Atomic Kaoru Asaka of Japan. We've got the Raven Queen of the Shadowfell. And finally, last but certainly not least, they call her Daddy Zombie. Boom. Boom. Elimination Chamber. I already forgot the order. I think I put them in the order that they're in the Discord. So this should be easy for pulling up the entrance music. Elimination Chamber. Oh, She Fancy. Blue Siren. Jawzette. Kaoru. Raven Queen. Zombie. I'll get 10 minutes for this one. Following contest, folks, is an elimination chamber in the women's division. As with all elimination chambers, the winner is awarded a win. The losers do not have to suffer a loss. Introducing first, entering one of the pods. Oh wait, what the fuck? Why is Kaoru coming out? Oh fuck, it's because it's random. Fuck. I forgot about that. I thought this was Oshi Fancy coming out first because I put Oshi Fancy in there first. All right, introducing first, making her way to the ring from Tokyo, Japan. She is Atomic Kaoru Asaka! If you can't tell my persona, I sell propane and propane accessories. That's valid. Alright, who's next? The random order is gonna kill me on this. We're gonna have to see who comes out. Alright, Jawzette, this is fine. We don't have Jawzette music. And introducing second, also in a pod. Making her way to the ring. We don't know where she is because Jawzy won't tell us. Jawzette! Just watched a back K-Merc and I lost in normal knee fashion. What was that? How I was taught, which can be totally the wrong way to say it, a barbecue is like a smoker. You are just not cooking it as long as you would for smoking. I don't go, you are grilling, not barbecuing, because they are interchangeable. The equipment is just where I say barbecue versus grill versus griddle. I just wasn't sure what indirect heat meant in this context, that's all. To be clear, I'm not like saying you're doing it wrong. I just didn't know what piece of equipment a barbecue was and compared to a grill. And their opponent, introducing third. What the fuck do we say? Drawing number three. Just rolling out of bed right now. Always back broken. Oh, She Fancy! Only one more opportunity for somebody to get a pod. Blue Siren, Raven Queen, there's somebody else in there. Zombie, Daddy Zombie. The other two will have to start the match. I think this is zombie.
I never thought
it is
essential.
And their opponent, drawing number 4, making her way to the ring from Dublin, Ireland. They call her Daddy Zombie. This song is an absolute slaptastic banger, by the way. Always back broken, she is. I'm gonna guess this is the Raven Queen. It's 50-50. The only other person left is Blue Siren. And it is the Raven Queen. Introducing their opponent. Starting the match within the ring by drawing number 5. From the Shadowfell, she is the Matron of Ravens. The Raven Queen! And not even by by Tajay. But apparently, Fancy was in here earlier. She said that Tajay ain't come by recently. We're gonna have to have some words with Tajay. You can't just leave Fancy hanging like that. Who's gonna break her back if Tajay ain't there? We have 2 big green eggs. Oh, I know about the green egg. I think as long as, in the grill conversation, as long as you're having fun and you are, like you're breaking bread with homies. You are welcoming them into your home, or you're being welcomed into someone's home and you are partaking of the act of sharing food together. And their opponent, making her way to the ring, drawing number 6 from the lost city of Atlantis by way of the Isle of Queens, Blue Siren! I like doing smoked deviled eggs on mine. First of all, smoked deviled eggs is such a white people food. Second of all, I fucking love smoked deviled eggs, bro. They're so good. It's so white, but they're so good. Does Blue Siren have an aisle fit? I'd love to see it because this new season fit is fire. It is fire, isn't it? Oh, fuck. We're gonna have to do the camera thing. Hold on. Oh, this feels so weird with the PS5 camera. Camera controller. Alright, this should be enough to not cause vertigo and still allow us to see everything in the ring. Right off the bat, the Raven Queen putting Blue Siren in a Paradise Lock, and we saw the Paradise Lock get a KO in the Enclave Enclosure match on Saturday. I didn't know how food had races attached to them. Ethnicities. Yes. And absolutely. Food is a very culturally influenced thing. 100%. Like, you're not, like, restricted to only liking or, not being allowed to like things that are outside of the culture that you grew up with, but deviled eggs are very much a part of white culture. No, smoked deviled eggs are? Well, both. If I have seen... That's not how I wanted to start the sentence. I have seen... If I had, like, a dollar for every time I had seen a meme, about white people food that was about deviled eggs and how white deviled eggs are, I'd have a lot of dollars. Hey, oh, there's an S in it. I'm so white, I put raisins in my potato salad. I will never be that white. Absolutely not. Potato salad is simple and it is sacred. It's your fucking mashed potatoes. Eggs are even optional. You don't even have to put eggs in it. But you got your mayonnaise, you got your mustard, and your dill. Dill and or dill pickle. With the potatoes. That's all it is. And you mix all that shit together, and I could eat that for the entire rest of my life. Also, a paprika. Paprika's in there. Nice step up in Zagiri by Kaoru coming in. Eggs are not optional to potato salad. They absolutely are. Mustard does not go in potato salad. Mustard is like the primary ingredient of a potato salad. What do you mean, Drew? I do 50-50. I do 50-50. I don't use yellow. I use Dijon. That's my preferred mustard. Yellow is fine, though. I just prefer, like, the more softer notes of a Dijon than the sharpness of a yellow. But yeah, look up any potato salad recipe. It's going to tell you do both mayonnaise and mustard. 100%. More mustard-based potato. I like them both. I like them both. I think they're both good. If you were to give me two giant bowls, one of them more mayonnaise-heavy and one of them more mustard-heavy, I would eat them both, and then I would throw up because I ate so much potato salad. Cookie, when you go to visit Darius, I'd be honored to have you at my family's for a barbecue, homie. I think you'd love my family's barbecue dishes, by the way you talk about enjoying food. I fucking love food. Also, I appreciate that, Prince. I love you, homie. To me, like, part of the reason that I am, like, was a language major in college and I'm so infatuated, like, with culture and language is just how much it can bring people together. Like, few things can get you to understand another person than the language they speak. I mean, obviously there, but like how they speak the language and what their language means to them, and also the food that they eat. So many different people have so many different like food practices. Like, if I could do an Anthony Bourdain thing where I traveled the whole world to all these countries and partake of, like, traditional, like, dishes and in the way that they're served and, like, immersed in the culture, that would be, like, my heaven, man. My mother-in-law puts mint in her potato salad. I call it mentho potato salad. Menthol potato salad? Yikes, that's gross. Oh my god, zombie, what a big move to Oshii Fancy in the middle of the ring. I'm sorry for everybody that has a wrestler in this match and I've neglected to commentate, but let's be real. Potato salad is very... Was that a double cutter onto Oshii Fancy? Or double twist of fate? I didn't quite see the whole move. It looked like a double cutter. That was wild. But yeah, potato salad's a very important conversation to have. Yeah, respectfully, Cokes, I will never have your mother-in-law's potato salad. How we feel about ambrosia? Is ambrosia a real thing? I thought that was fictional. Is that real? Tower going for a pin on zombie right now. One. Oh, surprise roll-up by Jawzette! Imagine! All of Jawzette's characters just win via roll-up. That'd be wild. Ambrosia, the nectar of the gods? Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Ambrosia's a southern fruit salad, I think? I know of ambrosia from, like, Greek, Roman, etc. mythology. When I travel to see a friend, I ask to eat locally, and I ask to listen to at least some local music. For me, it's the best way to understand a region's influences. Yeah, exactly. I love learning about people's journey. That's probably the best way to encapsulate who I am as a person. I love to learn about people's journey. Which I think is what... Oh, wow! The talent of steel from the Raven Queen with the ref fucking on her! What? We're getting the upskirt shot on Fancy, too. Y'all getting that for free? Make sure to go sub to Fancy on Twitch. She gave you the panty shot.
Where's that referee?
Blue Siren kicks out at two.
He was trying to fuck on me.
Yeah, that's, Oh, the frozen tomb from Jawzette. Onto Oshii Fancy. Now going after the Raven Queen. They're fighting right underneath the camera. No eliminations as of yet. Fuck, what was I gonna say? But yeah, this community, like... What is this community if not learning about people's journeys? Because all talk about mental health is, right, is learning about someone's journey. It's a lot more than that, but at a very super simplified, concentrated form, learning about people, where they come from, gets you a better insight into how they operate, who they are as a person. And I think that's beautiful, and I think, what just happened? Blue Siren phased through the ropes like the Flash through a wall. Oh my god. Ambrosia is drained fruit salad, Cool Whip, and usually orange, but sometimes peach-flavored Jell-O packet. Like the you don't even make Jell-O, you just have powdered Jell-O with some Cool Whip and some fruit salad? I mean, that sounds like diabetes in a dish. So, like, it sounds sweet. It doesn't sound, like, outright bad in terms of flavor profile, just really, really sweet. I could have, like, a spoon of that just to get the taste of it, and that would be enough for me. With cottage cheese. You posted Ambrosia in IRL pics. All right, let's take a look at this. That looks disgusting. What? Is that like Parmesan cheese? Does Parmesan cheese go in this? No, don't put cheese. Cottage cheese? Oh man, no, it's been ruined. It's been ruined. Everything that was nice about this has been ruined. It isn't cheese. What is it in the bottom left? It's so good on a hot day. Some nice cold ambrosia is peak. I don't know. Being a New Englander. Oh, there's the Amityville Horror Special on the outside by Zombie. Onto the Raven Queen. Ref again. Slow on the count. 1, 2, 3. The Raven Queen is eliminated. Raven Queen, the first elimination of the match. Huge Uranagi from Jaws Zet. But the pin gets broken up by Zombie. Probably coconut flakes. Oh, okay. I fucking love coconut. I'll eat anything coconut. Oh, what was that? Oh man, Blue Siren looking for a Salita of some kind, but fancy turning it around. My mom's really sweet, but she's like, I'm gonna find the perfect words to technically explain her. She's open-minded, but also very opinionated and willing to have the hard talks, but she's very abrasive. Is she good about it though? Do you think? Unfiltered. Okay, yeah, there we go. 2, 3 Zombies out of here, and Jawsette's about to pin Fancy. Are we gonna get a double back-to-back elimination? 2, 3, we do, and Kaoru finds herself in the finals of yet another elimination chamber. Snapdragon suplex. This is the second, maybe third time that Kaoru has been in the final two of an elimination chamber. Jawsette telling her to get up. Kaoru, she said herself that she's got a lot to prove this match. Oh, knee to the side of the face from Jawsette. She's been in two, she won the first one. Off the top, what a huge leg drop from Jawsette. Oh my god, that's what killed the dinosaurs too. But Kaoru kicking out. She won the first one, excellent, good for her. This is the opportunity to be crowned like the queen of the elimination chamber. Lion Salt off the middle rope, and Kaoru kicking out at 1. Kaoru's still down. Jawsette trying her best, going to hit the ropes. What is this? Knee strike. Jawsette going up to the top rope again. If she hits another one of those big leg drops, it's over. Oh, Swanton Bomb, but Kaoru gets out of the way. Kaoru, this is her moment. She's got it locked in. Will Jawsette tap? The submission is locked in deep. Oh, Jawsette fighting out of it. Hits Kaoru with a sidewalk slam. Kairos down, Jawsette stomps away at her, flips her over, punches to the temple. was stomping at the face several times by Jawzet there. Speaking of which, where do Jawzet's allegiances lie? Who's to say that she has any? As she's just taunting randomly to nobody in particular. Oh, Karu, nice big reversal there. Karu, what is this? Hook and a leg, dragon screw from the atomic one. And look at this. Oh man, almost like a stump puller maneuver there from Karu after the dragon screw. The submission specialist, look at this, grabs Jawzet, but Jawzet hits the enziguri. Karu goes down, crawling away over the ropes. Pause, what I say, no pause. Irish whip. Into the ropes, coming back, dropping down. Oh, a spear! Spear from Jawzet, that's gotta do it! Jawzet going for the pin! 1, 2, 3, Jawzet wins it! Here is your winner of the match, Jawzet! Jawzet goes to 1-1. That's her first win of the season. Congrats, Jawzet, on a big win here. For that one, that's Jawzet. 100 cookies on Jawzet too. Congrats to whoever. Oh, Jawzy bet on Jawzet. Big payout. Coming up next, this is a base tag team match to see if the base tag team matches work between the Isle of Kings and the Merchants of Mayhem. Team King Cygnus and Godpock. Okay, King Cygnus, Kalthar taking on AO with Salty Pete. Oh man, I hope this works. With Toaster, no, with Toaster and Goblin Queen. Starting now. Faction music up. Okay. Alright, let me get caught up. Scroll up. First to every woman or feminine human being a bitch, but it's not because she's mad, it's just the word she uses for fem people. Oh my god. That's really funny. The following contest is a base tag team match scheduled for one fall with a 20-second ring out and a 25-minute time limit. They're getting jumped! I did not set this up. They're just getting jumped. The moms are jumping the aisle. Oh my god, what is happening? It's been a while since we've had an entrance attack. And Gabo and Toaster just appeared from nowhere. Oh my god, the Merchants of Mayhem are taking out the Isle of Kings right now. What is this? Talthar disappeared again. Oh man, that was probably Thaddeus. Tag matches are back to normal? Who's to say? Oh my god, the crocodile roll here from Ao with the strobe lights going off too. The entrance light show is still happening. Talthar, not again, yeah. No, this was Thaddeus, and he didn't want to get in the way of the moms in the aisle, two of his business partners. It's a setup. Talthar did this. He's turning. The game is kind of chugging right now. On the outside, Salty P punching Sig right in the face. Hey, yo, look at this. He's got a Cobra Clutch locked in. Oh my goodness, what a start to this matchup. I can't believe it. By God. Salty Pete sends King Cygnus into the ring. Godpox sends AO into the barricade. Oh, he missed the ring, actually. Goblin Queen sending Godpox into the ring.
Looking to upgrade.
In goes Cygnus. In goes P and AO, and the bell is probably going to ring. Oh, why is the bell not ringing? The bell is rung, AO. Corkscrew knee lift. Irish whip into the corner. Who is the legal man here? I have no idea. What is Cygnus doing? Ayo, hits a backcracker. Who's legal here? King Cygnus is floating in the sky. King Cygnus, what the hell is happening? Hold on. Why can't I control the camera? King Cygnus might be KO'd, folks. I can't change the camera angle. Cygnus, what is happening? Ref's counting too. Cygnus is still in his entrance attire. Godpox, a chop to the head. Why did Cygnus come back in? What is he doing? AO's getting to his feet. Yeah, they fixed something. They broke something else. AO fighting Godpox into his own corner. Snapmare takedown from AO, turns it into some sort of submission. What is... Sig is not in a taggable position. What is this cheating shit? Godpox punch to the face on AO, grabs him from behind. Misses, though. Jey Uso still on the Tron, true. They think that we're still in the entrances. They still have their entrance attire and everything on, too. Okay, yeah, I don't think base tags are fixed at all. I don't think anything is fixed about this. This is even more broken than it was, I think. Ayo, looking for the Dude Buster. On to Godpox. Connects. Ayo, go for the pin. Salty Pete is just down. He's not, Ayo, kick to the midsection. Looking for the gory special here. Will Godpox tap? It doesn't look like King Cygnus is at all interested in breaking this up. Ayo releases the hold. I'm not even sure if a tag can be made here. Ayo just waving to King Cygnus. No, it's fixed. It's just whatever this is bugged. Yeah. Oh, Sig punching Ayo in the back of the head. That's not where you're supposed to be, Sig. Referee, tell him to get back to his own corner. That's not his corner. Cygnus literally just dancing on the apron. Oh my goodness. Godpox. Oh yeah, exactly. And the same bugs that have been in here for years too, but this is hilarious. Godpox can't make the tag because Cygnus isn't in the appropriate corner. He doesn't know what to do. Godpox, what is this? Lifted AO up. I would like it to fix my frame rate. Godpox fell asleep after that one. I wanna give the computer a chance to fix itself. Oh wait, there's no time limit either. The time limit got broken. This is supposed to be a 25-minute time limit, and the time limit is not there, even though the bell rang. Going for a pin here on Infinite. Salty Peach just watching. Or on Infinite. I was too. Why is ref slow counting? What the hell just happened? He's leaving? He's going after the toaster! Why is Godbot attacking the toaster? Toaster gets sent into the ring? Why? I say restart? Absolutely not. No, this is gonna count as a win for the aisle, but I have no idea what's happening right now. This isn't elimination. Cygnus came to this side of the ring. What is going on? Oh my goodness. I don't know what's happening right now. Can they pin him again? This isn't supposed to be elimination. They're just beating the shit out of Salty Pete out here and there's no reason for it. Oh my god. All right, Godpock, what's gonna happen here? Are you gonna try and pin him? AO is just standing there. AO hasn't actually left yet. Salty Pete. Why? King Cygnus is on the wrong side of the ring. That's not even. All right. Let's see what happens if we restart the match. Let's see how borked it is. All right, Tautar's here. There's a code breaker. We'll give, and we got the timer back too, but there's also now no star rating, so 2K giveth and 2K taketh away. Godpock bringing AO all the way over to his quarter, but AO fights out of it. Frame rate looks a sword. Yeah, it does. That's true. I forgot about the frame rate too. The start of this match was bugged. There was an entrance run-in and the match, like, technically started, the bell rang, and there was a three count, but then after the three count, it was an elimination. AO was just standing in the middle of the ring, and the aisle went out and started beating up on the managers because they couldn't do anything else. Godpock tagging out to King Cygnus, who actually didn't even get to do a move in the last match. King Cygnus going up to the top rope immediately. What's he looking for? King Cygnus telling AO to get to his feet immediately. From the top rope, King Cygnus. Oh my god, Dragon Rana for a pin. One and a one count. AO, he hurt his head. Oh, bottom rope moons. What? AO, what was that? AO spear in the corner. He like kipped up and limboed underneath King Cygnus's moonsault there off the bottom rope. I love God was just beating the toaster's ass for no reason. That's part of the reason why I wanted to keep it official, was that Toaster, who had just like finished up his whole thing with Chaotic, the fucking AO just Kamehameha goddamn fucking King Cygnus out here. Toaster just got brutalized on the outside, which is very on brand for him. Just getting beat up profusely for no reason. What? Where's Beardfist? Dead. Yeah, I think he got dropped into a volcano. I think that's how the story went. King Cygnus going over, making a tag out to Godpocalypse. Tag is made. Salty Pete turns his back to Godpock, and Godpock with a pop-up Hurricanrana.
If he were left him, don't be asking.
I'll smoke to that, Salty Pete. Irish whip into the ropes, Godpock. Oh, he missed whatever he was going for. It turns out the Salty Pete is as slippery as his dick. Godpock, oh man, elbow to the side of the head. Going for a pin here onto Salty Pete. And a kick out before even a one. Not even a one that Salty Pete was down for. Grapple here, look at this. Oh my god, I thought he was going for a dragon screw, but Salty Pete be like, you're a stiff right hand, Lou. As he drops an elbow on Godpock's throat. There's two of them. Slippery Salty Penis. That's not what I said. I said his deck, like of his ship. Pete doing things? He is doing things, and he's doing them to Godpock, no less. Look at the salty big swinging inverted sit-out DDT. What is the name of that move? Aside from that, that's a very long-winded thing to say. Godpod gets in the ring. Salty Pete just lets him grab him. Into the corner. Was it a ruse, perhaps? No. I use pot of greed. I use a pot of pot. How do you feel about that one? Irish whip into that exposed turnbuckle via Talthar. Going for the pin. One. Only gets a one count. Talthar did the thing. Oh man, two arm wrench takedowns there. It never works that well. I guess they fixed it. You missed it. This is the second time we've done this match, Sig. You don't want to know about what happened in the first one. It was rough. I mean, technically the island won the first go around, but the game was broken in more ways than this game has ever been broken. That move is called Vertigo. Oh no shit. Oh, what is this? A flapjack from Godpock, followed by a kip up. Salty Pete turns around. The hot tag is made to AO. In he comes. AO. Oh my god! King Cygnus with a leaping knee over Salty Pete. Sends AO out of the ring. And then turns his attention to Salty Pete. That sounds amazing. We should have kept that version. I really wanted to. But, like, tags weren't possible. Nobody was able to tag into their partner. You were standing in the wrong corner the whole match in your entrance attire. And it was fucking hilarious, but I don't think it held up to the fidelity of EPW. Oh, what is this? AO sends King Cygnus out into the pit with the rest of the moms. It should be up right now. I set the VODs to auto-publish again, so they should be live as we are streaming. Ayo, Irish whip into his own corner here. Ayo, perhaps looking for a double team with Salty Pete. Let's go. Off the top, Salty Pete! What a torpedo! Nearly flipping! King Cygnus inside out, folding him up like some laundry. But the AI looks way better now. After the past couple of matches, I would agree. AI looks pretty good. Salty Pete choking the life out of King Cygnus, slamming his head right on the mat. Salty Pete, is he looking for the anchor drop? He ain't! No, that wasn't the anchor drop. One! That was a weaker version of the anchor drop. Oh, Salty Pete! What is this? Oh my god! Kokina clutch locked in from Salty Pete, and now he's eating Godpock's fingies. Here comes King Cygnus running Hurricanrana takedown. Godpock is out. Salty Pete's getting to his feet. He rolls out of the way of King Cygnus. Eats a kick to the face, blocks a chop, hits the right hand. Salty Pete sends King Cygnus into the ropes, fakes him out, chops him down. Salty Pete, where's he going? Goes to the outside for some reason. Salty Pete is walking around the arena. He's standing behind the toaster and the Goblin Queen. Okay, he's going to have a chat with Talthar. He's like, Talthar, did that check clear? Talthar goes to give him a hug. Salty Pete punches Cygnus twice. And AO as well. Yeah, I don't know what's happening. He wanted a weapon. It's a DQ match. This is a base tag team match. If he gets a weapon and uses it, he's DQ'd. He was just checking out to make sure everybody was doing okay on the outside there.
He's like, oh, hello, fellow moms. You got your beverages. The Salty Pete need to give you any slurty nuts.
Then he goes over to Talthar.
He's like, ah, Talthar. Good business doing with ye.
Salty Pete is just getting his sea legs. True, as he picks Cygnus up. Sends Cygnus into his own corner over here. No tag is made. Instead, he's wrenching the wrists or the biceps, whatever they're called. That's a part of the arm right there. Salty Pete gets elbowed in the face. AO is standing there, just watching. Salty Pete sends him into the corner yet again. He thought better of it again. Salty Pete, once more. Sig needs to tag, he sure does. He's been taking a lot of punishment at the hands of Salty Pete. But he's also got that Cleveland Steamer defense. Oh, Slingoblado rolling through, looking for the dropkick to the side of the head. This is Sig's moment. His opportunity to seize everything he ever wanted. One moment. On the surface, he looks calm and ready to drop bombs, but he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking now. Everybody's joking now. The clock's run out. Time's up. Overplow. Godpuck. Oh, look at this. Oh, my God. UFO PKO from Godpuck. 1, 2. And Salty Pete kicks out of the UFO PKO. Godpuck, where's he going? Oh, I think he was geared up to Fist of Fate. Ref told Pete, 90-second commercial. Ghost all true. Godpuck revving up. Turns around, just a knockout. Oh my God. Not quite the Fist of Fate. 2. Oh man, AO comes in, breaks it up. Oh, Fist of Fate to AO. AO gets caught with the Fist of Fate and sent into the referee, but Salty Pete grabs Godpuck. Godpuck sold a little bit. He gets busted open. And Salty Pete with an elbow to the jaw twice. Salty Pete grapple. Pop up punch to the face. And Godpuck. Oh, pop up. Hurricanrana to Salty Pete now. He's got to make a tag. He is profusely bleeding here. Godpuck grabbing Salty Pete, sends him into the corner. We're going to see a double team here from the island, perhaps. No, no double team. As Godpuck slams Salty Pete face first into the corner. Making a tag? No. Salty Pete fights out of it. No tag is made. And Salty Pete winding up like Popeye and knocking Godpuck right out. Going for the pin is Salty Pete. 1, 2. The Popeye smash, not enough to do it. Popeye spicy chicken sandwich available near you. $4.99. For the sandwich itself. Oh, Talthar getting involved with Salty Pete. They were having a business dispute. And Godpuck, ranch of the arms. Talthar's like, I'm sorry, Pete. I'm going to be day late and a dollar short. Not a sponsor, but yeah. Oh, kicking his leg out from under his leg, followed by a super kick. And Godpuck goes over to make a tag. That's AO's favorite move, by the way. That super kick to Salty Pete right there. AO's favorite move. Cygnus going out to the apron, going up top, could be looking for the Swanton Bomb. He wants Salty Pete to get up. Will he hit the standing Swanton? No, a dragon run out of Salty Pete, followed by the pin. 1, 2, and a kick out from Pete. I don't think that was a kick out so much as it was a nut bust based on that expression from King Cygnus, but we'll go with it. Cygnus sent into his own corner. Salty Pete, what is this? Oh, man. Dropping Cygnus down. And Pete, what is this? Whipping Godpuck around and going to town on Godpuck. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Godpuck goes down, but Cygnus gets the dropkick. Salty Pete playing with his food. Cygnus gets up, grabs Pete, sends him into the corner. Oh man, what a boot to the face by King Cygnus. 1, 2, and again another kick out. Salty Pete, how does he keep doing this? King Cygnus going on over, making a tag out to Godpocalypse. Salty Pete needs to make a tag himself. Godpock has his sights set on AO, thinks the better of it. Armbar into the DDT onto Salty Pete. Wrench it away in the Fujiwara style. Godpuck picking up. Salty Pete grabs him. Sends him into the ropes. What are we looking for here? Oh, they just kind of run into each other. And oh, Salty Pete with a Salty Pete press onto Godpuck. Oh man, what a error there by Godpocalypse. And he's getting his fingies eaten again. Salty Pete needs that iron in his diet. Yarr. AO gets tagged in. The Backcracking Assassin versus the Nightmare. Irish whip into the ropes from AO. AO's waiting. Grabs Godpuck, but Godpuck rakes the eyes. A super kick, he kicked his leg out from under his leg and he super kicks him again. AO getting hit twice with his favorite move. It's super effective. Did you see Toaster try and break up the pin by stomping on the ground? That was very funny. Godpuck picking AO up. pops him up. Samoan drop! Going for the pin, but Salty Pete is right here and breaks it up before a count of one. Godpuck, he's saying it's time for Godpuck Crush. Oh, AO. Oh, man. AO getting absolutely smeckledorfed by that one. Godpuck rolling through. Oh, man. Crocodile roll followed by a trip. Oh, my God. He's grabbing AO by the balls. Look at that. Grabbed him by the balls. AO gets up. Godpuck rolling through. Neck breaker. Oh, my God. No knee to the face. Godpuck on AO picks him up. Another grapple. Irish whips into his own corner. We're going to see a double team maneuver here from the aisle. No, we're not. Godpuck slams AO face first off the turnbuckle. King Cygnus is like just slightly outside of tag range, and AO gets out of it again. AO turns it. He gets distracted by Tal'Thar, but fights out of Godpuck's maneuver. Goes running, hits that knee strike. AO's got Godpuck all wrapped up. AO gets dumped to the outside. Oh my God, what a back and forth affair. And Godpuck going after Pete, punching him in the face. What is this from Godpuck? Oh my God, a snap suplex to Salty Pete. And Salty Pete no-sells it. But Godpuck's not done with him just yet. Oh. Oh, Salty Pete with a reversal. AO trying to get into the ring while Godpuck is distracted, but it doesn't work. Godpuck gets him. Armbar DDT. Locks in the Fujiwara. Oh, AO makes a hot tag. Godpuck was stalling. In comes Pete. Grapple is made. Irish whip into the ropes. Godpuck didn't. I don't know if he didn't realize it. Oh my God. Flips him over. V trigger from Godpuckalypse. On to AO. This is his moment. This is. If he's going to make the pin, it's got to be now. AO is down. Salty Pete's in the corner and busted wide open. Godpuck's going for the pin. AO's already in the ring. Ref does not see the rope break. And Salty Pete kicks out anyway. There was a rope break. Pete's foot was well underneath that bottom rope.
Where is
referee
that referee?
Did not call it.
He was trying to
Godpuck
fuck
pop
on
up
me.
Samoan drop. And that ought to do it. Oh no, AO still has his breakup. And he breaks it up at the last second. Godpuckalypse. Full named him. God Herbert Pockalypse. I swear I will turn this car around. Godpuck grabbing Pete. Irish whips him into the corner. And still, okay, tags are definitely not fixed. They can't do double team moves. Because as soon as a dude goes in the corner, the person that is non-legal walks away so that he can't be tagged. Godpuck stomping on Pete right now. Oh, oh my God. The G-bomb. From Godpuckalypse, as Pete rolls underneath the bottom rope. Pete's playing for time now. Pete's playing for time. He knows that the greatest weakness of the Isle of Kings is the time limit draw. Punches Sig in the face, grabs him from behind. Oh my God. Had the submission locked in and King Cygnus is out. King Cygnus took a nap. Pete going for a pin after six punches to the face. One, two, and a kick out from King Cygnus. Remarkable. Cygnus kips up. Salty Pete didn't see it. There's the Cygnus factor. Cygnus going up top. This could be, I don't think AO has a breakup. If he hits the Constellation Splash, it's over. No, Swanton Bomb across the ring. Going for the pin. It's impossible to see if the foot is under the ropes. But Cygnus does it. Perhaps there was a rope break, but the ref did not call it. Here is your winners of the match. The team of Godpuckalypse and King Cygnus. The Isle of Kings. Call them the Isle of Kittens? That's not what I called them, but it's what their name is now. The Isle of Kittens, because they're all so cute. Moms fall to 3-3, while the Isle of Kings stands alone at double-digit wins with 11-3 on a two-win streak. What a remarkable match. Individual records through that, we got AO in tag action. It's now 1-4. Salty Pete in tag action is 1-2. Godpock in tag action is 6-3. He broke a 2-loss streak. And King Cygnus in tag action is 3-1. Bouncing back after his first tag loss of the season. Coming up next, three-way between winless competitors here. As we have got Milkman, who's 0-1, taking on Mo Money, who's 0-2, taking on Deathblade, who's 0-2. One person will walk out of this match with a dub. I wish this was the Bear Hotel, bro. That's not even the Bear Hotel I meant. But when you reacted, I was like, oh, hell yeah, I'll go for that kind of Bear Hotel, too. Bear Hotel is actually my nickname in high school, believe it or not. The following contest, folks, is a triple threat elimination match. There are no disqualifications, no countouts, and falls count anywhere. Introducing first, making his way to the ring from parts unknown, Deathblade! I don't tell him I'm trying to milk this all the way to the top. What are you milking? Ref, what was that? Call the rope breaks when they have. Oh, in character, let's go. Hell yeah. Prince, I respectfully request that you do not milk the referees before, during, or after the matches. That's probably not good for their... Well, I mean, it might give them post-nut clarity. But never mind, carry on. You know what you're doing. I talked myself into it. This is a song, all right. And introducing next, his opponent, making his way to the ring from the dumpster out back of Denny's, the Milkman. I don't believe it. What don't you believe? That match was a dumpster fire? Oh, speaking of dumpsters, here's the Milkman. No, this is Patrick. Ref, prostate cancer levels at all-time low. Oh my goodness. You can't milk me. You can milk me as a ref once. Oh God. Instead of the green room, we got the milk room. I hate everything I just said. Why do I open my mouth? Oh my God. And their opponent, making his way to the ring from Staten Island, New York, Mo Money!
Oh,
Oh my goodness. Mo money. Making it rain, baby. I got nipples, Greg. Can you milk me? Oh my goodness. I really gotta read the sentences in my head before I read them out loud. The cookie out of context clip video is gonna be wild when it drops. Yo, if somebody could make that, I'll suck your toes. Man. Collar and elbow tie at middle of the ring. Deathblade and Mo with milk right here as well. No, how could you do this? How could you do this to me? Oh, what a spine buster from the milkman. You should call it like the intestine buster is actually a thing. A fucking, I don't know, butt buster. Ass blaster instead of a spine buster. Anyway, Deathblade drops the milkman with a DDT. Add that to it. Oh my goodness. Oh wait, yeah, what was my nickname in high school that I just said? I've already forgotten. I know I said that something was my nickname in high school. I don't recall what it was. I do not like that the out of context fucking clip URL has echidna in it. Y'all know about echidna penises? That's fucked. Inquisitive Jazzy Echidna. Grammar King. Not a grammar king. Oh, look at this double arm underhook from the milkman. Oh man. Tiger bomb. Pause? We don't pause around here. We let the thoughts flow freely. Milkman standing shooting star. Mo money behind him. Irish whips him into the ropes. Mo, nice hip toss. Don't say that about Knuckles. Did you see that Microsoft is coming out with furry Sonic and Knuckles controllers for like in honor of the new Sonic game or whatever? They're literally fuzzy black, or not black, blue and red controllers. Oh man, what a back elbow there. Deathblade ripcord knee, and then here comes Mo with a bulldog. From behind, they never saw it coming. Mo drops the elbow right in the solar plexus. I did, I'll pass. Yeah, say that in public. But we all know you bought it. Irish whip out of the ring. Watch a couple yesterday, Neuro knows about Sonic inflation. Good. Does your stream still say XCOM? It does not, no. Those controllers are going to be so grease 1 week, 1 hour in, bro. Oh, look at this. Deathblade going for the pin. Remember, there are no rope breaks in a false count anywhere match. So the referee was fine on that one. Oh, nice sidewalk slam from Deathblade. Milkman has been busted wide open. His milk has turned into a nice shade of strawberry. Double arm motor hook, tiger bomb again. On to Deathblade. The referee didn't expect the pin to happen. Maybe I need to refresh, so that's better. Hell yeah. Nice soft reset for the Twitch browser, everybody. Exclamation point, soft reset. If you haven't already, have we had a meds check? Has the meds check button been hit? It has. Somebody hit the meds check. I'm gonna guess K-Merc hit it when he came in. But make sure you take your meds. I did take my meds during the morning meds check. But if you got evening meds, if you got dinner time meds, before bed meds, make sure you take them now or set an alarm to take them for when it is meds time. Mo, why are you breaking that up? It's an eliminator. This is an eliminator. You don't care if the people get pinned or not, buddy. Oh man, now Deathblade's busted open. Mo, I think, is the only person not donning the crimson mask right now. Augustin, nowhere. Oh, Mo, he's like matrixing, punching three guys at once. Two guys even. He punched himself in the face on that one. Milkman can't maneuver Mo Money into the direction that he wants to maneuver him into. Deathblade grabs Mo by the back of his head, sends him into the ring, but that allows the milkman from behind to send Deathblade into the ring. ST counts, it does count, yeah. Irish whip, whoop. Right hand, left hand, kick to the midsection. Look at this, another tiger bomb. This one's gonna be on the chair. Oh man, right on the chair. Panda, or not panda, milk loves his, oh man. His tiger bombs, they're making a Shrek 5. Are they actually? I guess Mike Myers like needs his, like what is it, tri-yearly, not like annual, try every 3 year paycheck or whatever to make sure that he's still got money. One, kick out at one from Deathblade after getting hit multiple times on his face on the chair. Gotta keep the SAG benefits, exactly. Let me tell you about some SAG benefits there. They're releasing until 2026, but still. I mean, it's the movie series of our people, right? It is the millennial movie. It is our Lord and Savior, a Shrekus Shrek. I can't wait until Shrek, like how Jedi is a religion on the census. I can't wait until we get like Shrek is love, Shrek is life as a religion on the census. That would be a good time. I will dedicate my religion to Shrek. Coming on over, Mo Money. He's just watching, hanging out. He's got that hockey stick, clocks Deathblade in the back of the head with it. Goes after the Milkman, but the Milkman, he's had his fair share of run-ins with a hockey stick. He is a raccoon. Oh man. Milkman, forearms to the back here of Mo Money, but Deathblade gets involved, and Deathblade now has drawn the ire of the Milkman. Man, that is one mean raccoon. Grapple here. Deathblade, headlock, turns it into a flatliner, drops the Milkman face first on the hockey stick. Now he's sizing up Mo Money. No, he picks up the hockey stick. Oh my god, spanks Mo Money with it. Taps out the Milkman, spanks Mo Money again. And again. Oh, Mo Money kicks it out of his hands. Mo Money with a back elbow to Deathblade. Now Mo Money wants the hockey stick. Oh, and now he breaks it over the back of the Milkman. Mo Money looking for the money shot. Who's gonna get it? Oh man, everyone, there's the money shot on the Deathblade. Deathblade eats that money shot right up. One, two, and a kick out. He kicks out of the money shot. Oh man. This is Mo Money's money shot and not Nick Cannon's money shot, so not quite as powerful. But there's a big pump kick from the Milkman. One, and a kick out at one from Mo Money. It goes for a chop, but Deathblade catches Milkman into a tombstone. Oh, man. Well, Mo is just kind of watching as Deathblade makes the pin. Deathblade pinning Milk. One, two, three. Milkman's been pinned. The Milkman has been pinned. Lil B-Dem, welcome in. That's a lovely name. How are you doing? Oh, man. Kick to the midsection. Doesn't work. Oh, man. Big clothesline takedown. How are you doing, Em? Happy Tuesday. I hope your evening is going well. Welcome on into the cookie jar, where we are a mental health safe space community. We're doing wrestling right now, so the homies in chat can duke it out with their fisticuffs and their promos and their roleplay. It's like a sportsy D&D. But yeah, it's a good night. You're good? How am I? I am doing great. The past couple of days have been fantastic. We've had some really good mental health talks. Very, like, insightful time, pleasant time with everybody. Oh, kick to the midsection from Deathblade. I'm glad to hear that you're doing well. Oh, look at this. Last ride from Deathblade! Wait, that's not... He's going for more? He wants to, like, bury Mo Money right here. Looking for the tombstone. Can Mo Money get out of this? If he doesn't, this is Deathblade's match to win! Puts Mo Money down with the pin. Does he stick out the tongue? He doesn't stick out the tongue, but one, two, three. Deathblade with both referee? Pins.
He was trying to fuck on me.
Oh my great googly moogly. Here is your winner of the match. Deathblade. Deathblade picking up his first win in EPW. Congrats, homie. Deathblade, the rookie, goes to a one-win streak. Overall record of 1-2. The Milkman falls to 0-2 on a two-loss streak. And Mo Money falls all the way to 0-3. Oh my god, look at the blood mixed in with the face paint. He's having a heck of a time there. A heck of a time, I tell you. Just wrestling for the fun of it? Well, you just wrestled for the win, too. Big congrats, homie. Let me pay out those predictiones. Oh, all of it went on the Milkman, and since Deathblade won, that's a void right there. It's only 10 cookies, but goes into the void. All right, coming up next, my friends, we've got a base singles match in the women's division. We're Ion Flux. This is between the Destruction Doll and Aurora Lights. Because I don't think I've ever paired these two up one-on-one before, and this seems like it would be a good match. Go get him, DD. PJ, I got the spray bottle ready, bud. It's already ready. Destruction Doll is 2 and 3. Oh fuck. Does Destruction Doll have music? No. The following contest is a base singles match scheduled for one fall with a 20-second ring out and a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, making her way to the ring, she is the president of the unofficial Mirko fan club by way of the Isle of Queens, the Destruction Doll! Destruction Dolls 2 and 3. Yeah. Aurora Lights is 4 and 5. 5 minutes on the clock. Predictions are up, my friends. Predictions are up. Eric, hello. Good evening. How are you, my friend? And her opponent, making her way to the ring from the Borealis itself. She's a mama six, so you know she don't take no shit. The Aurora Lights. No, my 10 cookies. All 10 of them gone forever. No longer in the cookie economy. Gonna be 6 and 9. No, PJ, no. That was really good, but that's worthy of 2 bonks at least. Oh my goodness, 1 for each of you. You heard him, ladies and gentlemen. Place your fucking bets, guys, gals, and non-binary pals. Gender is a social construct, my friends. Right hand from Destruction Doll, putting Aurora Lights up on their shoulders, and then a forearm to the back of the head. Not too bad, tired after working, beeping and bopping. Hell yeah. Hi, y'all. I'm doing good. I'm doing very good tonight. Had some tacos for Din Din on Taco Tuesday here. Got some wrestling going. Joe Hendry is gonna probably be on NXT tonight. If that happens, when that happens, folks, let me know when Joe Hendry shows up. Because I want to see the pop. I want to see the pop. Regardless of whether or not we live. We might not be live when it happens. If we're not, like, post in the Discord. I want to see. Oh, man. Big kick from Aurora. Onto the Destruction Doll. Destruction Doll throwing her off, though. Again. Twice. Third time. Not the charm. On the 4th attempt, Aurora Lights is able to square up with Destruction Doll. And now just going to town with these punches at the face. Forearm after forearm after forearm. Destruction of currency is a federal offense. Not when they do it. One. Kick out at 1 from Destruction Doll, but the first pinfall lands on 1. Seeing is believing, and we believe in Joe Hendry. We sure do. Say his name and he appears. I would love it if Joe Hendry showed up here. Just to be like, hello, viewers of EPW. And then he writes a song about how awesome Jazzy is or something. Aurora. Oh man, eats that running knee strike from the Destruction Doll. Oh, and then raking the bottom of the foot across the face. Speaking of anime, summer 2024 anime is gonna be great. Pretty sure Demon Slayer, summer 2024, yeah. Oshinoko season 2. Man, I'm so hyped for Oshinoko season 2. That has easily made it into my top 3 anime of all time. All time. It's a fucking slaptastic banger. Goes for a low kick, but Destruction Doll catches it. You can't kick Destruction Doll. She's the kicking queen. Kicks right to the chest. Doing good, making a new attire for QLG. Oh, really? We did do a republic here, so we kind of broke some laws. What? Going underneath? Destruction doll pop up. Oh, knee to the midsection and a kick to the back of the head. No republic here anymore. Oh my god, what a big kick from Destruction Doll. One, two, and a kick out at two. Oh, like the Anarchy Republic, yeah. Also, that's an oxymoronic name, just for the record. Go for, nope, no pin here. I thought Destruction Doll off that crossbody was gonna go for a pin. She doesn't. But this match has been all Destruction Doll, and she's looking for the destruction kicks to put this one away. Oh, but Aurora blocks it, it's a super kick. That's AO's favorite move. Oh man, Aurora reversing the destruction kick with AO's favorite move, the super kick. Big clothesline from Aurora. Another big clothesline. Oh my god, and a single leg drop kick. Destruction Doll's down, Aurora's going for the pin. One, two, and a kick out at two. These two are exchanging two counts. Aurora. Hell yeah, getting on up here. Aurora, right hand, flips Destruction Doll around. Here we go, Aurora. The Aurora lights out from Aurora Lights. One, two, three, Aurora turned it around. Unbelievable. Aurora lights out on the Destruction Doll, picks up the win. Here is your winner of the match, the Aurora Lights! Very much coming into this match as an underdog against the multi-time Women's World Champion Destruction Doll. Aurora herself, of course, has challenged previously for the Women's World Championship, was unsuccessful when she challenged the Goblin Queen. Could be looking to work her way back up. She just broke a 3-loss streak there against the Destruction Doll, who now herself, after that loss, is on a 3-loss streak. Coming up next, we've got the Emperor versus Goliathus. This is another match where I was like, damn, I don't remember the last time I've seen this match, if we've seen it in this form at all. That being the Emperor, or Eagles in general, take it on Goalie. Singles, Emperor, who's 7-6. Taking on Goliathus. Who is 6-6. Don't worry, Eagles, I'll get your music in a sec, bud. The following contest is a base singles match scheduled for one fall with a 20-second ring out and a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, making his way to the ring from the fifth circle of hell residing in Kyoto, Japan, the Emperor Oni! I can make a black and white one as well so we can match. Hell yeah. That'd be kind of sick, not gonna lie. I do love the red and gold, but it would be hilarious if you had one that tried to match the panda, like with panda eyes and all. Oh my god, that's amazing. If Talthar disappears again, the turn is real. True. Big true.
If you feel so filthy, so dirty,
Holy shit. I just tapped over to Discord, and we have a, like, a Discord chat for the mods. And it has been popping off, I didn't realize, because when streamer mode is on, like, you don't get Discord notification sounds. And the notification number was 69, and Coke took a screenshot of it and sent it to the group chat, that there were 69 notifications. Yeah, I gotta hit that with a nice, too. Nice, Coke, nice. Me clicking on it cleared the notifications for me, and I didn't even think to look at what number it was at. See y'all later, it's time for gym time. Have a good night, Lamenti. Enjoy the gym times. Get at me later for music talk. Absolutely, absolutely.
Thank you so much. Best friend.
And his opponent, making his way to the ring from Long Island, New York, by way of the Isle of Kings, accompanied by Talthar of Talthar, Talthar, and Talthar. He is the captain, Goliathus! Yeah, be very safe, Lamenti. Drive your bike safe, however you get in there. Let us know when you get back, okay? There might be some NXT-age going on in the hangout in Discord. Go Lee! You're just in time! It is your match, homie. Taking on Emperor. There's still 80 seconds left in the voting. 7-6 versus 8, or versus 6-6. I, too, am going to try and get in on this, do something physically active, so as to live longer-ish. People do that? Whatever Big Fitness wants to sell us on. Big Fitness was actually my name in high school. Big Fitness, dick in your mouth, Cokes. Got him. The living world is a unique and spectacular marvel. I walked right into that one, you sure did. Billions of individuals and millions of kinds of plants and animals, dazzling in their variety and richness, working together to benefit from the energy of the sun and the minerals of the earth, leading lives that interlock in such a way that they sustain each other. We rely entirely on this finely tuned life support machine. And it relies on its biodiversity to run smoothly. Similar to Earth, the Enclave. That was a very good mix of, like, David Attenborough with the fucking the narrator of Twilight Zone. And now I'm running away from it. there's a Pickles from last time. And there's my car keys. And there's my ride. Emperor right now working on Goli. Collar and elbow tie up, Irish whips him into the ropes with the fake out in the knee to the midsection. Emperor crying out in fury of some kind. The Oni inside taking over. Oh, Goli gets an elbow up in the face, flips the Emperor around, but Emperor with an elbow of his own, fighting back. Grapple now. Emperor walking Goli all the way to the other side. Goli with a couple of well-placed mastications. No, not mast. Fucking... Weenus, well-placed weenuses to the penis of eagles. The weenus is the tip of your elbow. And the penis is the penis. Going for a pin, one. There's a two count. Two count there from Goli onto eagles. Stop it away at the chest. Backing up Goli. Oh, man, another kick to the chest. Oh, Talthar throwing in a steel chair. Goli looking for the wicked stepsister. Panda. Pro Wrestling Org adopted a wild panda in their company, allowing the natural and contemporary world to work together. The director being one of the first humans opening their hands to this wild animal, with QLG sharing a bamboo and the rest of next episode on Dragon Ball Z. Oh, holy wow! What a, like, cyclone kick to the face of the Emperor, who fights out of it immediately. What a no-sell from the Emperor. Kick to the face here on Goli. Very back and forth kind of affair. Emperor sends Goli. No, fakes him out, but Goli, he's seen that trick a time or two. Grabs the Emperor. What is this? Kicks him. Two, three kicks to the chest. Goli now grabbing the head of the Emperor. Kicks him in that lumbar spinal region and then in the chest. Goli telling the Emperor to come forward, and then a kick to the face as well. The sole of the shoe going to the tongue of the eagle. Kick to the dick from the Emperor. Emperor grabbing Goli. Going underneath. What is this? Hammerlock. Flatliner! But he lands on his back poorly. Goli's been working the back all matchup. Emperor gets up, but Goli with the bicycle kick. Grabbing the legs of the Emperor, working on the hamstring. I feel like Panda needs to be a villain now, just hating Canadians. No, the Canadians are the bad guys. They're the foreign heels. Ooh, boo, Canada. Boo, freedom. Boo, universal healthcare and taxes. They're the bad guys. One, two, and a kick out at two from the Emperor. But no, traditionally in professional wrestling, the foreigner, regardless of what country, is the bad guy. So in Japan, the gaijin, they're always the foreigners. Doesn't matter what gaijin you're from, you're gaijin, you're bad guy. In the US, if you're Canadian, if you're Mexican, if you're Puerto Rican, even though Puerto Rico is still part of the US, if you're not a red-blooded American, brother, you're a foreigner and you're a bad guy. What is this? Oh my God. Goli, what the hell was that move? You just killed the Emperor. Could be a German versus a Mexican. We'll still chant USA. Exactly. Exactly. Because that's the American way. Goli, what is this? Oh man, what a kick to the face of the Emperor. While this matchup started, the first 5 minutes were very back and forth. This has turned into Goli's balance. What was that? Goli. Oh man, getting the elbow up, but the Emperor eats a kick, two kicks. Eats a punch, roundhouse knee to the face. Goli, he made a mistake, but he course corrected immediately. That's why he's the captain. That's why he knows what he's doing, why he's been so successful the past two seasons. He may make mistakes, but when he does, the course correction is immediate and it is serious. On the arms, bam, Kami Goye to the head of the Emperor. And Goli's getting all hyped up now. Calling for the end, perhaps. Those are those AA cannons. Going up top, Goli looking for the Goli bomb. No, not the Goli bomb. What's he doing now? He wants Emperor on his feet. Goli, a karate kick off the top rope. Going for a pin. One, two, three. What a way to win from Goli. Oh my God. Holy shit, the top rope karate kick. What do we call that one, Goli? Here is your winner of the match, the Captain Goliathus! Goli goes to 7-6. Emperor falls down to 7-7 in that one. Goliathus on a 2-win streak. Coming up next, we've got the director taking on, speaking of Canadian heels, he's taking on Mesolas of the Canadians. Predictions are up, 5 minutes on the clock. The director taking on Mesolas. Mesa Last and the Canadians, of course, absolutely dismantling the team of the Tree Warriors plus the director on Saturday, and doing so with a brutality completely uncalled for, being honest. Following contest is a base singles match scheduled for one fall, with a 20-second ring out and a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, making his way to the ring accompanied by Shadow Walsh. Oh, I've never seen Shadow Walsh in this entrance before. From Toronto, Ontario, Canada, Mesa Last! Do they even have bamboo up north? They don't. They don't have bamboo, yet their lack of bamboo has proved superior to us every step of the way. Mason and Shadow. A force to be reckoned with here in the Enclave. Wouldn't be me, am I right, boys? Big same. Abby, what's going on? Stop throwing Nanners hands. Fucking, let me throw some VTuber stabby at you. What do I got? And his opponent, making his way to the ring from Salem, Massachusetts. He is the CEO of Enclave Pro Wrestling, the director. None of them have animated violence emotes that I am currently subscribed to. But... I'll do this, so this is a great emote. All right, base singles match, folks. One-on-one, there are countouts, there are rope breaks, there are disqualifications. This is pinfall or submission within the squared circle. Let's get it on, director, square it up with Mesa Less. Irish whip into the corner, but fakes him out and clotheslines him down. Ferret walk, get your ferret walks in here. Ferret walk for infinite. I know I got a ferret walk in here. Oh, goes for the headbutt and misses. The director hits Mesa Last with a right hand from behind. Look at this hammerlock applied. Director elevated inverted DDT off of the hammerlock. Learn that one from Christian Case over in Pushstar Media Wrestling. The director again. Look at this. Turns. What is this submission from the director? Don't even know what that was, but Mesa Last hits him with a stunner. Director's jaw hurting. Mesa Last picks him up and, oh, just scoop slams him down. Leg drop as well from Mesa Last of the Canadians. Mesa Last picking the director up. Goes for a body punch, but the director fights back, slaps him in the face. The director gets slapped in the chest like karate. He karate chopped me in the chest, bro. What the fuck? Knife edge chop followed by a right hook. A slap to the face followed by another right hook from the director to the face of Mesa Last, who wants more. The director goes for a chop, but Mesa Last fights back. That's two. Director gets reversed upon Mesa Last, chops him. Director fights back. Mesa Last hits a right hand. Director, right hand. Oh my God. The director with a reversal, and they just go to town. They just start beating the piss out of each other, Director and Mesa Last. Right hand after right hand. Director wins the collar and elbow tie-up, grabs Mason by the back of the hair, but Mason hits the left elbows right in the director's tum-tum. Grapple here, Mesa Last fakes him out, and a clothesline takes him down yet again. Director gets up, no sells it. Irish whips Mesa Last and does his own fake out, says anything you can do, I can do slightly almost the same. Director grabbing Mesa Last and punching him right in his forehead. Going for a pin here from the director. One, Oh, 1.9 there, almost a two count. Director with the Vulcan nerve pinch applied, trying to release some of that tension out of Mesolas's neck. Director, big clothesline onto Mesolas. Another big clothesline. Three clotheslines in a row. Mesolas up in the corner. The director's got him right where he wants him. I don't actually know where the director wants him. Director, what is this? Oh man, puts the leg up and kicks the hamstring out from underneath him. Director, what is this? Batter up, big home run from the director onto Mesolas, who skirts his way underneath that bottom rope. Mesolas gets right-handed by the director. Shadow's just watching this. Mesolas is eating it for breakfast. He reverses the third right hand and gets into the ring, but the director catches him with his hand in the cookie jar. Director for the win, hand in the cookie jar. One, two, three, the director gets his revenge. Let's go. Here is your winner of the match, the director. A modicum of revenge on the Canadians here. The director goes to 2-3 on a two-win streak. Oh my goodness. Mesolas, he walked right into it, came inside the ring immediately. The director put his hand in the cookie jar, and that was that. Coming up next, singles match between Infinite and the Overseer, who's being accompanied to the ring by the Ice Geist. Don't forget about the, what do you mean? What? Was that a thing that was supposed to happen? Faction, Slight Pandemonium. Oh, this is an interesting. They both come out in the promos.
Slight Pandemonium.
These promos were posted well after the match card. I didn't even know promos were posted after the match card. Following contest is a base singles match scheduled for one fall, with a 20-second ring out and a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, making his way to the ring from the boiler room under the stairs, the Overseer, accompanied by the Ice Geist. No, they got ready for this music, Infinite. Woo! All right. And his opponent, making his way to the ring from Long Island, New York, by way of Integral, he is the Air General, Infinite! Director can beat the Canadian. Sure wish any of Integral could. Yeah, imagine not being able to beat up on a Canadian. How bad at professional wrestling do you gotta be to lose to the Canadians? I had lost mid-sentence what I was saying. ADHD be strong sometimes, baby. Yum, 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 yum. Let's get it on, folks. After this, we've got our double header of main events featuring a triple threat. Elimination tag in the women's division for the number one contenders for the EPW Women's World Tag Team Championships, extraordinary, whatever we call them. Women's Tag Champs. And then the main event is Broken Trey taking on Prince Socio, False Count Anywhere, EPW Television Championship. Hitting the ropes. Oh, big elbow drop there. Knee to his face from the Overseer onto Infinite. What would this? Oh my God! The Overseer just punched him right in the dick. Right in the dick he got punched. Oh fuck. I didn't put up predictions. Hold on. Overseer. Infinite. Predictions are up. Bam. Happy belated birthday, Trey, indeed. What is this belly to belly slam there? Huge belly to belly from the Overseer, who's now going for a pin. One, gets a one count on Infinite, but not a two. Infinite kicking out at two. Kick to the face. Fighting out. Has Trey gotten his computer fixed? Is he in the process of that? I am not up to date on the happenings. I know that his computer bricked on him the day that he was, like, literally on his birthday, when we were supposed to have the next BPW show. Oh, man. Oh, look at the Ice Geist removing that turnbuckle as Infinite is shimmying now. What is this? Oh, okay. Oh, man. I thought he was looking for a Bronco Buster, but then he did that to the Overseer. Infinite stomping on his kidneys now. What is this? Infinite sizing up. Oh, going through the Kinshasa, but the Overseer gets out of the way, hits like a drop toe hold, sends Infinite into the exposed turnbuckle and a neck breaker. But Infinite no-sells it. What? Oh my God, what a perfect maneuver there from Slight Pandemonium, and Infinite's just like, nah, undo button. The referee is over there fixing the situation. Overseer with a big reversal, kick to the midsection. Infinite flips him around, punches him in the face. Infinite from behind. Catches the Overseer. He's looking for the stabilizer, but the Overseer reverses the stabilizer. He's seen it too many times. It doesn't matter who's doing it. The Overseer recognizes a stabilizer. Infinite with the reversal. Oh, the Overseer pounds. Oh, a pounce. Big pounce, kind of, from the Overseer. Just absolutely yeets Infinite across the ring. Infinite kicks him in the face. Gets to his feet. High kick. Chop to the face, two chops, kick to the midsection, DDT to the Overseer, followed by a pin. One, two. Oh, what is this? Springboard crossbody, the referee taking the chair that Ice brought in and tossed it out. Oh, right hand, Infinite from behind. Unpretty bulldog from Infinite to the Overseer. Big maneuver there. Infinite, another shimmy here. Holding up the ones. Overseer gets to his feet. Infinite punches him. Infinite grabs him. Infinite plants him with another DDT. I was going to say plows him. But I didn't. Only except I did afterwards to tell you that I didn't. Infinite shimmying for like the 10th time in 9 seconds. He kicks the Overseer in the head and goes for a pin. Very disrespectful. One, two, and the Overseer kicking out again, but it looked like he had trouble doing it. Infinite picking the Overseer up. Is he looking for the end? Grabs the Overseer, Irish whips him into the ropes, fakes it out. Neck breaker from Infinite. And he's touching the mat. He's reaching up towards the heavens. He's saying it's Infinite loop time. Oh, but the Overseer with the surprise roll up, the most devastating move in pro. Ref, you didn't need to run all the way around the ring. You could have gotten a one count on that. Infinite running Hurricanrana takedown. Oh, Overseer goes to that bottom rope. Kick to the midsection from Infinite. Infinite punch to the face. Tosses the Overseer to the middle. What is this from Infinite? Oh my God, a corkscrew crossbody. What a maneuver from the Air General. And Infinite's looking to put this one away. He says Infinite loop, whatever it takes, it doesn't matter. Because I'm about to win this match. Infinite, whatever it takes, but the Overseer again reverses. Overseer saw it coming, sends Infinite into the ropes and hits the spear. The Overseer with the spear. 1, 2, and Infinite kicks out. The Overseer nearly put Infinite away after dodging the whatever it takes. Big knee strike from the Overseer. He's got Infinite right where he wants him. Overseer looking around. Oh my god, a boot to the face, but Infinite kicks up. Infinite grabs the Overseer now by the back of his head, but the Overseer fights out of it. Sent you a DM and an idea for an affiliation. Trey match reminded me, and I need to send the message before I forgot. You know, the weed brain bee. Hell yeah. All right, well, check it out, Prince. Thank you. Give it a snapmare takedown. Kick to the back. Going for a pin here after a snapmare kick to the back. 1, 2, 3. Okay, here is your winner of the match, the Air General Infinite. Okay. Infinite, go into, I didn't put the records because we started the predictions late. That was certainly an ending of all time. Infinite 6-2, he breaks his loss streak. The Overseer is 1-3. All three of those losses in a row. Next matchup here. We've got the Isle of Queens featuring Big Bertha and Valerie Venom. Yes. They are taking on Yokai and Sister Kara, who are taking on Death Star Express, Andy Takata, and Daisy Deathkisser. We'll see why we can't do that, Prince. That seems fine. Star predictions 2v2v2, number 1 contender match. Elim, Isle of Queens, Church of Chaos, Death Star Express. 10 minutes on the clock. Fuck, who's coming out first? Isle of Queens, I think. I want to do a Valerie's theme song. They got good music for this. I gotta fix the Isle of Queens entrance. But the following contest is our co-main event of the evening. And is a triple threat tornado elimination tag match. The winning team will advance to affiliation and challenge for the Enclave Pro Wrestling Women's Tag Team Championships. Introducing first, Artie in the ring, the team of Valerie Venom and Big Bertha, the Isle of Queens. Big whoopsie there. And their opponents making their way to the ring, the team of Sister Yokai and Sister Kara, the Church of Chaos.
me, not even a little bit. Nowadays, everybody's so sensitive. Watch the world burn!
Thank you for the single cookie? Hell yeah. I'm a married cookie, though. These three teams have been hovering around that World Championship, World Tag Team Championship picture since the start of Season 3, when we debuted those Tag Team Championships. Of course, Death Star Express, who we're coming out next, our first ever Women's Tag Team Champions. Their way to the ring, the team of the Lucky Star Andy Takata and Daisy Death Kisser. They are the first ever Enclave Pro Wrestling World Tag Team Champions, Death Star Express. This match, triple threat, falls count anywhere, elimination. Last team standing. Air drumming with pieces of my new rear rack for my bike while I put it together. Hell yeah. Let's get it on. Again, this is the co-main event of the evening main event television championship match between Prince Socio and Broken Trey. Big power bomb there from Yokai. On to Andy Takata. Another power bomb. Sister Kara over there getting a shin smash versus, or rather, combination dragon screw maneuver by Big Bertha. Valerie off the springboard, goes for the enziguri and doesn't quite get there. And here comes Andy Takata. Oh my God. Hey, that's gimmick infringement, brother. That's the the Japan tsunami suplex or whatever. Big Bertha stealing. Coming on over, bam! Big Bertha on Daisy Deathkisser, makes her kiss that top turnbuckle. As now Andy and Valerie teaming up on Sister Yokai. Valerie sets their sights on Sister Kara. Collar and elbow tie up here. Big Bertha and Andy, right hand, a chop. What is this? Oh my God, a Hiranagi for the pin on Andy Takata. One, two counts already onto Andy. Mere moments into this match, there is no time limit, no countouts. It's anything goes. Only one team can win. A couple of punches to the face here from Yokai onto Val. And now going to bite on the fingies. She's not, they're not even in her mouth. She was like rubbing her fingers in her own eyes. What was that about? Oh, grapple here. What was this? Oh my God, a go to sleep from Yokai onto Andy Takata. Valerie, they're laying down on the mat, writhing in something. I don't know, it'd be pain having that done to your fingers, but we'll see. Andy, cool lucha stuff! Oh my God. Am I watching how you got escorted out, or am I waiting for something from you? The cameraman brought you the video to watch of me fighting the security. He ain't getting dragged out, hell yeah. Fight the security. Oh man, German suplex there from Valerie. And a rainmaker onto Yokai from Valerie Venom. Big Bertha grabs the hockey stick and yeets it at Daisy Deathkisser, allowing Sister Kara. Look at this, the combination of Big Bertha and Sister Kara. You didn't know you needed it in your life. Not even a one count though. Big Bertha, deadlift gut wrench suplex onto Andy Takada. Getting Andy up to her feet. Big Bertha, a left hook. But Andy fights back with a punch to the gut. Oh, Kara with the booty attack. Kara sends Big Bertha into the corner, but here comes Val. They're helping their tag team partner. Oh, what a drop kick from Daisy coming across the ring, flying into Big Bertha's chest. Val fights out of Sister Kara, grapple here. Sister Kara, out of the ring. Val grabbing Yokai. Brings Yokai over to the ropes, over to her tag team partner. Oh man, Codebreaker. Val sent out of the ring by Yokai. Yokai grabbing Val. Flips him around. Oh man, one, two. Andy Takada on Sister Kara over there on the left side of your screen. Slingo Blado rolling through for that dropkick, and both members of Death Star Express have singled out Sister Kara on the left screen, on the left side of your screen. Oh, Tejana Bomb in the ring on the table from Sister Yokai, who goes out of the ring to try and help her sister, Sister Kara. My sister, but her sister, all of our sister. Kara's all of our sister. Sister Yokai coming with the chair. Oh, Irish whip into the ropes. Big Bertha pop up, goes for the, oh, the Styles Clash by Big Bertha with the pin. Ref's getting in the ring, but Yokai kicks out of it immediately. Traditional wrestling takedown. Oh my God, Valerie yeeted the trash can at Elidia. The referee doesn't see it because of the submission in the ring. Big Bertha accidentally goofing on their tag team partner. Bertha has Yokai in the ring. Going for the inverted Alabama slammer on the Sister Yokai. Yokai fighting out of it, kind of like a no-sell. Daisy Death gets around Sister Kara, sends her into the stairs. Val looking for a punch on Andy Takada. Andy Takada reverses. Flippy dippy all over the place. A PJ Majin special, kind of. Modified Fujiwara off the tilt-a-whirl from Andy Takada. In the ring, Yokai going to town on Big Bertha. As Elidia grabbing that table, sets the table up. But Yokai is there. Yokai from behind. German suplex. Rips her around. Ripcord Lariat. And Elidia doesn't go through the table. I thought Elidia was going to go through the table. That was insane. Great googly moogly. Into the ring goes Val. Yokai grabs a steel chair. Hits Val right in the back with it. I hear the government. Oh, fuck. Daisy, excuse me. Daisy Deathkisser. Punch to the face here from Sister Kara. Daisy getting elbowed in the face by Sister Yokai. Out of the ring goes Daisy Deathkisser. It's when commentators name drop somebody like, When they say like Daniel Bryan instead of Bryan Danielson or something like that, that's all. So if any names are gonna get said, oh fuck, Phil Brooks. Chick Magnet Phil. Oh man. Bertha just dropped the ref. Typical aisle behavior. Ref is down. Oh, Dragon Cutter! Outside of the ring, Space Crusher from Andy Takada. Onto Big Bertha, and then cracks the guitar over Big Bertha. Going for the pin. If Andy's gonna do it, this is it. One, two, three. Big Bertha's gone. Andy Takada eliminates Big Bertha. Valerie not fast enough. Andy Takada swing out neck breaker. One half of the Isle of Queens is out of here. Elidia in the ring. Primal, fucking Daisy in the ring. Primal Slayer on Sister Kara. Sister Yokai comes in and breaks it up. But Death Star Express is already off to a very strong start. Daisy gets sent out of the ring. Oh man, face first into Valerie. Andy Takada throws the table on like five different people. Basking in her own greatness is Andy Takada. Sister Kara is out cold, and never mind, she's getting back up. Oh wow. Huge move from Andy. Andy. Oh, Sister Kara attacking her own tag team partner. Super kick from Andy. Sister Kara, kick to the midsection. The space wizard from Sister Kara onto Andy Takada. One, two. Andy's gone. The space wizard got her. Oh, Sister Kara breaking up the pin from Val. Suddenly, the Church of Chaos has a major advantage as Sister Kara hits Sister Kara on Valerie Venom. Sit out powerbomb from Eladia. Kara trying to get over there and make the pin. But Daisy stealing the pin. One, two, three. The Isle of Queens has been eliminated. It's Daisy Deathkisser versus the Church of Chaos. Sister Kara, Irish whip. Into the turnbuckle. Sister Kara putting Daisy up on the top rope. Sister Kara, what is she doing? From up top. Way up top, Sister Kara. Oh my God. Superplex from Sister Kara. Oh my God, and Yokai with the hockey stick breaking it. Oh my goodness. Yokai, right hand. Onto Daisy, another right hand onto Daisy. Oh, the third right hand misses, but Sister Kara's there. Into the ring comes Daisy, who gets mandible clawed, and that's probably gonna do it. Sister Yokai with the mandible claw for the pin and the win. One, two, three. Here are your winners of the match, and they get their rematch with Slight Pandemonium at Affiliation for the Enclave Pro Wrestling Women's Tag Team Championships. Sister Kara and Sister Yokai, the Church of Chaos. What is happening with Sister Kara? She's praising the church. Oh my goodness. Church of Chaos wins it. Some would say that the Church of Chaos lost to chaotic circumstances back in Pandora's box. Isle of Queens go to 4-4. The Star Express go to 3-5. And the Church of Chaos goes to 4-3. They're on a 2-win streak. Finally, folks, it is our main event of the evening Falls Count Anywhere match between Broken Trey and Prince Socio. Boom. Main event of the evening. Predictions are going up right now, my friends. Andy, Daisy, Karu gonna end up in a lucha cage or some shit, all together with each other. The following crab trap match, the following contest is our main event of the evening. And is a Falls Count Anywhere match scheduled for one fall for the Enclave Pro Wrestling Television Championship. Introducing first, making his way to the ring from Cleveland, Ohio. He is the CEO of Broken Pro Wrestling, Broken Trey. Broken Trey coming into this match 4-6, and while he may have a negative win percentage, he's coming in on a huge 3-win streak. He has clawed himself out of the jobber title contention, of which he held since the start of season one, before finally overcoming Joker just this past pay-per-view at Pandora's Box to lose that jobber title. Finds himself in a television championship match for his birthday. which is something we do around here. If you got a birthday, on your birthday, let us know. We will schedule you for a television championship match. We give out the TV title match for a number of personal accomplishments. If ever you have those real life accomplishments, big, small, or somewhere in between, we want to celebrate you. There ain't enough celebrating of the homies' accomplishments out there in any capacity across the world. We want to be a place where everybody feels valued as people and that we're celebrating you for deserving your celebration. Even if you don't think you deserve it, we think you deserve it. And his opponent, making his way to the ring from Gary, Indiana, by way of the Isle of Kings, he is the Enclave Pro Wrestling Television Champion, the Wolf, Prince Socio!
I've never been a fighter, but when I bleed, I feel the fear just wash right
Prince Socio
over
in
me.
His second reign no as television champion. Taking the belt off of his friend, his comrade, his brother, PJ Majin. 1 week ago today, it was a hellacious match. One of two that PJ Majin had to defend in that night. And while he fell to his brother, PJ did manage to retain the Heritage Championship. But this will be the second defense of the Wolf. He fended off Supreme Knight on Saturday. Can he take on Broken Trey here tonight? Broken Pro Wrestling, the most 2K of 2K feds? No kidding. Prince versus Trey. A match we have not seen in quite some time, actually. Not at all this season. Broken Trey has more than earned his way up to this position. An opportunity to wear that purple belt. Why are we just getting a view of the ramp here? Hello, cameraman? Was that supposed to be our shot of Trey? Was just looking at the ramp? Did he get Mike Wazowski'd? Trey, here you go. Take a look at the purple belt. Trey, of course, former Intercontinental Champion here in the Enclave. He came out red hot his rookie year, 6-0, won a tournament, won the Intercontinental Championship, and then had an open challenge his very first night as champion. And who answered that challenge and ultimately defeated the undefeated rookie Trey but Jawsy himself for Jawsy's first reign as Intercontinental Champion. As Prince coming out the gate very strong, several right hands to Broken Trey, takes him to the mat immediately. So if my birthday comes around, I'll get a shot at the TV title. Yes, yes you will. What do you mean if? When your birthday comes around? Broken Trey, swing out neck breaker, collar and elbow tie up from these two, Trey. Oh, looking, oh my God. Teardrop suplex there from Broken Trey. By the back of the head. Broken Trey, putting Prince down. Mine is August 7th, wink, wink. Oh, I'll give you something for your birthday. Is your birthday February? My birthday is the February 33rd. Oh, left hand from Broken Trey. Look at this on the apron, the hardest part of the ring. My day, mine is 2 days after April 1st, otherwise known as April 3rd. Our realtor hit us with that joke the other day. It was literally, what was it, Friday? Friday was the 5th. We texted her and we're like, hey, hope you had a good 4th of July. And she's like, happy day after the 4th, also known as the 5th. And I thought that was like, hey, that's such a dad joke. Mine is actually Thanksgiving this year. Let's go. I'm thankful for you, Prince. Can I stuff your turkey? Pause. I'll take that back. Val, please don't kill me. Hey, somebody had to make the joke. I was just breaking the ice. That's all. Prince immediately, can you be my turkey to stuff? I mean, yeah, absolutely. We can have a turducken. We can have a chicken inside of a duck inside of a turkey. Yeah, that's totally doable. Mine is occasionally on Father's Day. Mine is, I guess, occasionally on the first day of winter. The winter solstice. But I just like to say that it's the first day of winter every year. Prince going for a pin immediately. The ref fucking on him, though. Only, not even a one count. My birthday is the 21st of December. And in my book, being born on the winter solstice, every birthday of mine is the winter solstice. The label lock locked in here from Broken Trey. Crossface. Presents in Turkey, lucky. Hell yeah. Yo, Presents in Turkey was my nickname in high school, actually. I remember, actually, this was something for the National Honor Society. They did a homeless awareness, and that's what it was called. That's what it was called. Not to call them homeless, because we like using unhoused around here. But that's what the fundraiser was called. It was Homeless Awareness Night, where they'd literally camp out in tents in the fucking football field. But yeah, that's what they called me. Presents in Turkey, because that's what I brought them. Brought the NHS kids presents in Turkey. And they're like, hey, it's presents in Turkey. What's going on? For 4 years, presents in Turkey here. There you go. The nickname's got lore now. Someone once had the audacity to question in what context I could have a particular nickname. And now I got to give all the context. I'll give too much context. Damn it, they took it, the sledgehammer. Prince, we have banned the sledgehammer as a weapon in EPW after what you fucking did with it. Going for a pin. But no, Prince kicking out. Again, not a one count. Neither of these guys down for a one count yet. Broken Trey picking up Prince. Iris whips him towards the referee, but he trips down. Poor Josh. Yeah, Josh still hasn't recovered from that. Oh, big shot from Broken Trey. A slap to the face. Triple H should be so proud. He probably would. Prince on the outside. No, Prince. A Styles clash on the outside, rolling him over for a pin. Prince Socio, we can't even see the pin, too. But Broken Trey kicks out. Hasn't been seen since he got banned. He got re-banished back to hell. That was so many sledgehammer shots. Trey chopping the throat. Goes for the kick to the midsection, looking for the pedigree, I think. But Prince, Trey. Okay, you had a chance, bud, but this is, oh man. I think that's the new lunar eclipse. Either way, thanks for coming. 1, 2, 3. Here is your winner of the match. And still, Enclave Pro Wrestling Television Champion, the Wolf, Prince Socio! Prince on a 3-win streak. Big congrats to him. Hell yeah, homies. Great show. Great show. Yeah, happy birthday. Oh, is Josh going around saying my name's Jeff? No, Josh is like in a coma or something. He's having a hard time. Quick recap of the card tonight. Opening contest. Supreme Knight took on Trap Reaper in a hellacious match. Supreme Knight absolutely manhandled Trap Reaper at the end of that one. Wasn't even close. Elimination Chamber, Oshi Fancy, Blue Siren, Jawzette, Kaoru, Raven Queen, and Daddy Zombie. Final two, Jawzette and Atomic Kaoru Osaka, who has really made a name for herself in these Elimination Chamber style matches. Jawzette coming out on top for that one. Next, we had the Isle of Kings take on the Merchants of Mayhem. The Merchants of Mayhem attack them before the bell. There's some sort of chicanery that happens, and the referee counts to three, but the director insists that the bell wasn't rung to start the match, and so the match was restarted, and still the Isle of Kings won over the Merchants of Mayhem. Following that, Deathblade picked up his first win in EPW, and a triple threat between Windless competitors, the Milkman and Mo Money. Destruction Doll took on Aurora Lights, and Aurora Lights showing that being a mama six ain't nothing to fuck with, as she hit the Aurora Lights out, and it was lights out for the Destruction Doll. the Emperor took on Goliathus in a base singles match, and while the first half was a very back-and-forth affair, the second half of the match was very much dominated by Goliathus. He came out on top. The Director versus Mesa Lass of the Canadians, a bit of a revenge match here from the Director, having a conversation with Mesa Lass. Director comes out on top after catching Mason Ra in the cookie jar as he entered the ring. Overseer versus Infinite. Infinite, he missed a couple of big finishers. He missed a stabilizer, he missed a whatever it takes. Nearly got pinned after a spear from the miss whatever it takes, but the Overseer came out. Or the Infinite came out on top, kicked out. Hit a snapmare takedown followed by a kick to the back. And that was all she wrote there. Semi-main event, Isla Queens versus Church of Chaos versus Death Star Express, number one contendership for the EPW Women's World Tag Team Championships. That's too long. Women's Tag Champs. It was the Church of Chaos that came out on top. Daisy Deathkisser, last woman standing as the resistance against the Church, but she didn't really stand much of a chance. Dark match, I know the answer is no. No. What about the match I was in? What about the match you were in? We're going to a recap of the card. You won the match, Deathblade. That was your first match. Miss 100% of the shots you don't take. Wayne Gretzky, Michael Scott. That's true. Cokes, we'll have behind the scenes again soon, bud. Don't worry. Like, we'll be back 100% to normal after affiliation. I'm playing a lot of Final Fantasy. And I'm supposed to be streaming to Final Fantasy on the Friday mornings and the Tuesday mornings. But because I didn't stream yesterday morning, we moved to XCOM to this morning. But we'll be back. All Thursday is going to be Final Fantasy. Don't worry about that one. We're coming back with that. But yeah, main event, Broken Trait. We just saw it. Taking on Prince Socio. Prince Socio kind of slobber knocked him a bit there. Football's almost here. Football is almost here, and we will be having Cookie Jar Community Fantasy Football League this year again. If you are interested, we're not even gonna, like, that's something for well after affiliation, like end of August is when that's gonna start up, so we still got a solid month, but that is on the way if you're interested in that kind of thing. Thank you so much, Infinite, for hitting the raid button. We are gonna raid out, and we're going into my VTuber mama tonight, homies. We're going into Caterin. She's playing some Phoenix Wright. And I like showing the support over there. I really like her art. I really like her vibe. Their community over there is very good. Very solid people. Very welcoming homies over there. Very warm community. Definitely a cookie-approved safe space. In the meantime, everybody, thank you so much for hanging out with me today. This was a beautiful Sunday, both in the morning and at night. Know that even if it doesn't feel like it, you are enough. You are worth it. You are doing a fantastic job. And I love each and every one of you oh so much. Have a good night, everybody. We will not be back here tomorrow because I got to get more dental work done. I have, like, enamel crowns, I think they are, or something. And they're replacing them with, like, the real ones. I've got temporary ones in, and they're replacing them with the real ones tomorrow. So no stream tomorrow, but we'll be back on Thursday, like I said, some Final Fantasy. Maybe some Morning Tactics Ogre, since I'm not quite set up for the numbered Final Fantasy games 1 to 16. But definitely Final Fantasy on Thursday, and then Friday morning stuff, and then Saturday morning cartoons. No Friday night stream. Anyway, I love you all. Take it easy. Say hi to Kate. I'm going to be hanging out in there for at least an hour. I love watching Phoenix Wright. Have a good one, everybody.